Welcome back everyone, this is Joe. In this very short video today, I am going to walk you through using relative dates. So we are here in our DSBB underscore Power BI 2 worksheet. If you do not have this, please go back to the very last video. And as always, I encourage you to go all the way back to the very beginning because we've been building in this series one video after another. So everyone who has followed along has this file. If you don't have it, just try and pay attention. This is a pretty easy concept, so I think you'll grasp it just by watching this. But we're here, expand our fields, and in this data set we have, as most of you know, 1800 all the way to 2016, but you're not always going to want to see all of those years. It is pretty common to just filter on like the last 10 years, the last 20 years, whatever. You don't want to publish too much out there, especially if you're publishing files out to the Power BI service. So let's just say we want to see the last 10 years from today. So we can very easily expand our DSBB life expectancy table, expand filters, and you could do it either filters on this page or filters on all pages. I will take the entire like top hierarchy portion first of the new year, or first of the year. Don't pull in the hierarchy because it won't recognize year, quarter, month, day, this auto time intelligence as an actual date. We need an actual date time to do this. So basic filtering, you can do relative date or relative time. Again, you won't be able to do that if you drag in year, quarter, month, or day that was auto created from the auto time intelligence setting that we talked about last time. So drag this in and then put it on all pages or on just on this page, but I'm doing it on all pages in case we make another tab. Do relative date, and then you can do is in the last, and I'll do 20 years. And keep in mind that this data set only goes up to 2016, and it's gonna do 20 years from today back. So just 2002 to 2022. So it'll only go 2002 up to 2016. So just keep that in mind. But generally when we're publishing data sets out to the service, if you're going to do that, you'll have updating data through today. But just so you know the difference between these, anything that has calendar in front of it includes a full year. Calendar months is a full month, calendar weeks is a full week. So if I did calendar years, it would not include 2022 because it's 3/27/2022 right now and the year is not done. So it will only go up to 2021. So I'll do up to today, so in the last 20 years, including today. Click apply filter, and now you'll see this update, and we have 2004 to 2016. Actually, it looks like we have 2003 to 2016, so that works. It is still filtered on 1801 or whatever you had last filtered, but after you select a new date like 2016, that 1801 will go away. That's just sort of a quirky Power BI thing, and really it's as simple as that. This is out here now. If you are publishing this out to the service, you can hide it or lock it. This just means your users wouldn't be able to actually change it if it were locked, and they wouldn't be able to see it if it were hidden. So you could do one, both, or the other. I'm just gonna leave them both off right now. And now you can see that if we did have data updating every single day after the turn of the year, it would drop off the last year. So the 21 years back would drop off, and that's usually what you want. You know, at work right now, we usually do like a rolling 2 years, and this makes it easy to do it dynamically. You don't have to go in on January 1st and redo your date range. So that's why it's super helpful. Save your work. That's it for this one, and we'll see you in the next one.